If you're making a game, do not use OneDrive or Google Drive. You need source control. This ensures you'll never lose your project and you can safely experiment with changes. So in this short video, I'm going to tell you how to set up source control. First of all, why? It lets you back up your project to a website like GitHub. It lets you experiment with changes by creating separate branches of your code. And it's crucial for working in teams. So how? First of all, go and create an account on GitHub, then download GitHub Desktop, sign in using your GitHub account. If you don't see the sign-in option, you can access it from here. I'm going to show you how to add a project that you've already created in GameMaker into GitHub. Click on Create a new repository on your local drive, enter the name of your project folder in the name field here, and then for the path, go to the folder where your project folder is located. For example, my project folder is called Car Fighter, so I entered that as the name and then pointed to the GameMaker projects folder where the Car Fighter folder is located and all my other projects are located, and I use that for the path. So you can see that the final path shown here for the repository is the exact same as the path for my GameMaker project. Click on Create, your local repository will be created in the folder where you had your project. And it should have created an automatic first commit for you. Now we need to store this online on GitHub so it's backed up online. Click on Publish Repository, enter the name of your online repo and choose if you want to make it private or public, and then click on Publish. Your project is now published and stored online. You can click on View on GitHub to see the online repository, and all of your project files will be here. Now you can make changes to your project, and in GitHub Desktop, they will show up under changes. You first need to save them into your local repository, so enter a summary of the changes here, write a description if you want, and click Commit. Now your changes are stored locally, but not online. You can click on the Push button to upload your changes to your online repository. You can see here the number of commits that you've made locally, but they haven't been pushed online yet. So click on this to send your changes to your online repository, and you can then see the new commits on GitHub. Now by default, we are working in the main branch, but you can make as many branches as possible. Once you're inside a branch, any changes you make stay inside that branch only. So every branch is like a different project. Changes in one branch don't automatically carry over to any other branch. For example, you can make a new branch to test something experimental and then commit your changes. And then if you come back to your main branch or any other branch, it will be the same as before. So you can click here to create a new branch, give it a name, and now you are inside that branch. You can switch between different branches from the same menu. Now, let's say you like the changes you made in the test branch and you want them in the main branch. So while being in the main branch, you can click here to select a branch to merge into main and then choose the branch you want to merge. So for me, that's test. This will merge all the commits from the selected branch into the currently open branch, which is main. So that's just scratching the surface of source control. But we've covered the two most important things, online backup and branches, so your project is always backed up and you can safely experiment with new changes. Now go and set up source control for your project. You can download GameMaker from the description. Hope you enjoyed this video, and I'll see you in the next one.